It's so damp outside. It's really high humidity. I needed to do something different instead of the bird photography that I've done really much lately. So I needed to try to photograph the red deer. So I'm in the forest right now. I'm going to have a little look outside this field here. And yeah, just wait here. I really, really enjoy waiting for red deers. Has been almost a year. So, and it's good to do something different than bird photography right now. So I'm going to go on the spot that I'm going to sit down, and I'm talking to you later. There's one deer now, just disappeared in the woods, but I'm guessing it's coming out of the woods really soon. Finally something happened. There's a buck just in front of me. I think it was that deer that I saw in the slope there, but I didn't see the antlers, but now I see them. It's pretty challenging because the wind direction is not in our favor. There was two females coming down, but they were like sniffing in the air and caught our scent. But they are still in a little hillside there. So what I'm going to try to do is to include a little bit more of the environment and like put the animal small in the frame. I don't know if it's going to be good, but that's the only hope that I have of getting any pictures today. But that could be a good training for me, because when I'm photographing birds as well, it's so easy for me to like getting everything close, but including the animal or birds in the environment, it's so much harder. So it's good to train on that, because you can get a lot of cool images just to do that. So that is what I'm trying to do now.